Hello, my dear friends. Let's continue with the topic of molecular basis of inheritance. So far, we have covered about DNA, RNA, genetic material search, DNA replication and transcription in our previous videos. Now, we are going to see about the next contents about molecular basis of inheritance. Coming to the note, the RNA polymerase is also called as DNA dependent RNA polymerase because these RNA polymerase will add the RNA nucleotides from the DNA. So, through the transcription process, from the DNA only the RNA will be arrived. Because of that, we call it as DNA dependent RNA polymerase. RNA polymerase 1 is found in nucleolus, helps in synthesis of rRNA. Hence, the nucleolus we call it as ribosome factories of cell. RNA polymerase 2 helps for the synthesis of mRNA. RNA polymerase 3 helps in the synthesis of tRNA. So, ribosomal RNA is an insoluble RNA. Pribnow box, it is a DNA sequence found in the promoter region of genes in prokaryotes. It has a sequence of TATAATG. So, Tata box, the Tata box or Goldberg-Hoeganess box is a DNA sequence found in the promoter region of the genes in eukaryotes. It has a sequence of TATAAT. Coming to the concept of gene. Gene is the basic unit of inheritance that express the specific character. In 1857, Gregor John Mendel conducted the hybridization experiments with pea plants. He called them as factors. In 1909, a Danish botanist, Johnson, proposed that each portion of chromosome that controls a phenotype, we call it as gene. So, in Greek, gene means to give birth to. So, in 1941, George W. Beadle and Edward L. Tatum discovered that genes control the production of enzymes. They proposed one gene, one enzyme hypothesis. So, 1944, Oswald T. Avery announced that DNA is the substance responsible for heredity. In 1950, Watson and Crick discover the chemical structure of DNA. The gene is made up to a specific sequence of DNA nucleotides. So, Symer Benzer proposed the modern concept of gene while working on Escherichia coli and T4 bacteriophage. According to him, gene is cistron, recon, muton, replicon. Coming to this first concept, what is cistron? It is a structural gene. It is the functional unit of DNA that codes for a specific protein. So, the DNA sequence which codes for a specific protein, we call it as cistron. Recon, it is the unit of DNA that undergoes recombination. We call it as recon. Muton, it is the unit of DNA that capable to undergo mutation is muton. Replicon, it is the unit of DNA that undergo replication. Under the name only, what is the exact meaning is there. So, recon which undergoes recombination, muton mutation, replicon replication. Genetic code, the three specific nucleotide sequence that codes for a specific amino acid present in DNA, we call it as genetic code or triplets. Codon, the three specific nucleotide sequence that code for a specific amino acid present in the mRNA, we call it as codon. So, genetic code is present in the DNA. Codon is present in mRNA. Anticodon, the three specific nucleotide sequence that codes for specific amino acid present in anticodon arm of tRNA, which we call it as anticodon. Anticodons are complementary to codon. General features of genetic code. The genetic code is a triplet. Each code is made up of three specific nucleotides and the genetic code is universal. Each codon code for a specific amino acid in all living organisms. Genetic code are no overlapping. So, adjacent codon never shares their nucleotides. Genetic code is commaless. There is no gap between the neighboring codon. Genetic codon is degenerative in nature. More than one codon codes for a single amino acid. For example, GUA, GUG, GUC and GUU code for valine. So, these are the genetic codes and these are the amino acids. So, we have the first letter in this column, second letter and third letter. Okay, so first letter, second letter and third letter. For example, first letter U, second letter U and third letter U. So these code with phenylalanine, leucine. Initiator codon. AUG is an initiator codon that initiates the protein synthesis. It codes for amino acid methionine. Terminator codon. Among 64 codons, so in this picture totally we have 64 codons. Among 64 codons, 3 codons UAG, UGA, UAA does not code for any amino acids. These are called it as terminator codons or nonsense codons. So genetic code is unambiguous, means each code for specific amino acid and only one amino acid. The codon UUU code for amino acid phenylalanine only. So the genetic code is unidirectional in nature. Code reads only in 5' to 3' direction. Vowel base. In each codon, 3 nitrogenous base is less specific. So GUA, GUC, GUG, GUU code for valine. So our transfer RNA or tRNA. The RNA that carries and transports activated amino acids to the site of protein synthesis, we call it as tRNA. It represents about 10 to 15% of total RNA in the cell. The polynucleotide chain is folded on itself to have a shape of clover leaf. So the shape of tRNA is clover leaf. The clover leaf model of tRNA was proposed by American biochemist Robert Holley in 1965. He shared the Nobel Prize in Physiology in 1968. So here is the picture of Robert Holley. Structure of tRNA. So the tRNA is single-stranded polynucleotide chain. It folds in some region and resembles a trifoliate leaf of clover plant. So from that the name, it is a clover leaf model. It contains 4 arms. So we have the 1, 2, 3, 4 arms. So 1. So first arm is amino acid binding site to acceptor. So this is the acceptor arm, ACC. This is the acceptor. And TUC, so arm and loop. So TUC, arm and loop we have. DHU, so arm and loop. So this is the DHU arm and loop. TUC arm and loop, DHC arm and loop. Anticodon arm and loop. So this is the anticodon arm and loop. Rarely small fifth arm is present, which we call it as variable arm. So the 5' prime end has methylated guanosine. So 3 prime end has 3 free nitrogenous bases, which is CCA. So this is the 3 prime end, and this 5 prime end has methylated guanosine. So each arm has a paired base pair stem and unpaired base pairs loop. Okay, each arm has a paired base pair stem and an unpaired base pairs loop. So this is the paired base pair stem. So this is the stem and unpaired base pair loop. So this is the loop. So amino acid acceptor has 7 base pairs and 3 unpaired base pairs. So at the CCA, at the end 3 prime end. Therefore, amino acid always bind to adenine present at the 3 prime end. So TCC arm and loop contains unusual sequence of nucleotides as thymine, pseudouridine or cytosine. It helps to bind the ribosomes at the time of protein synthesis. So DHU arm and loop contains a dihydrouridine. It helps to recognizing the specific amino acid activating enzymes called aminoacylsynthase. So the anticodon loop contains 7 unpaired nitrogenous bases. Among them, 3 nucleotides acts as anticodon, which are complementary to codon of mRNA. So the function is, it carries a specific amino acid towards the site of protein synthesis. So because of the tRNA, transfer RNA. So here are the pictures of tRNA. So we have the 3D picture. Next, ribosomal RNA. rRNA is a structural and functional unit of ribosomes. It represents nearly 80% of total RNA in the cells. Coming to the translation, decoding of the coded information carried by mRNA into protein, which we call it as translation. So nothing but converting one form into another form, we call it as translation. Transcription means same code only but converting DNA code into RNA code. But in translation, we are converting the RNA into protein. Means we are converting the code into protein form. Or synthesis of polypeptide chain on mRNA strand with the help of tRNA and ribosomes, which we call it as translation. Translation takes place in cytoplasm. The required components for translation are mRNA, tRNA, ribosomes, amino acid, amino acyl synthase, peptidyl synthase, ATP, GTP, magnesium ions. The process of translation takes place by 5 steps. Initially, activation of amino acid. Attachment of activated amino acid to the tRNA. Okay, initially the amino acids in the cytoplasm has to get activated. Later, that activated amino acid has to attach to the tRNA. Initiation of polypeptide chain, elongation of polypeptide chain, and termination of polypeptide chain. First, activation of amino acid. The specific amino acid present in cytoplasm gets activated by specific amino acyl synthase enzyme and ATP. It forms a amino acyl adenylated enzyme complex. So amino acid plus ATP plus amino acyl synthase enzyme in the presence of magnesium ions, amino acyl adenylated enzyme complex plus phosphate. Attachment of activated amino acids to the tRNA. So the DHU loop of specific tRNA recognizes the activated amino acid according to this anticodon. So the activated amino acid binds to the 3' end of the tRNA. It results in the formation of amino acyl tRNA. So here it is attached to the 3' end. So amino acyl tRNA. So tRNA. So we have the enzyme tRNA synthase. So this is the activated, this is the whole amino acid. This is the activated site. And attachment of the amino acid to the tRNA. Initiation of polypeptide chain. So DNA to mRNA, mRNA to protein. So we are talking about this translation. So ribosomal. So bigger subunit and smaller subunit. And when the tRNA, so when the ribosome is reading this codon, the tRNA will bring the complementary to this. tRNA will bring the amino acid, which is complementary to this codon. Elongation of polypeptide chain. It is a linear growth of polypeptide chain on the mRNA, which we call it as elongation. The charged tRNA that carries the specific amino acid enter the ribosomes, so that attaches to mRNA next to the initiator codon with the help of anticodon. So the peptide bond forms between these two amino acids by peptidyl synthase. As the peptide bond forms the tRNA becomes uncharged, it leaves the ribosomes. So the ribosomes moves the codon by codon in the direction of 5' to 3' end. As the ribosomes moves over the mRNA, the coded information decodes into polypeptide chain. So this is the sequence of mRNA, and the tRNA has brought this. So tRNA with the complementary codon is bringing this amino acids, and it is forming a bond between this, which is a peptide bond. So the first amino acid joins to the second by peptide bond, and the first tRNA is released. And the peptide bond is formed, the first amino acid, so the tRNA will get released. And again the ribosomes move along the mRNA until the second tRNA is in the P site, and the process will continue. So the ribosome continue to move along the mRNA, and new amino acids are added to the peptide. Termination of polypeptide chain. So the termination of polypeptide chain takes place due to the presence of terminator codon called UAA, UGA and UAG. When terminator codon comes, it does not code for any amino acid. It leads to the termination of polypeptide chain. So the polypeptide chain synthesized release out from ribosomes. It undergo folding to form a specific protein. So the ribosome leaves the mRNA. So this is the whole polypeptide chain. Once it is fold become formed, it is been released. So once the stop codon has been arrived. So this is the new protein. Lac operon concept or gene expression in prokaryotes or inducible operon concept, all are same. So lac operon concept was first proposed by French biologist Jacob and Monod. Experimentally, they demonstrated the regulation of gene in Escherichia coli. Means how the genes has been regulated or controlling of the genes is been proposed by lac operon concept. An operon is a group of genes that are transcribed at the same time. So the sequential arrangement of regulatory gene, promoter gene, operator gene and structural gene in prokaryotes, we call it as operon concept. So this three structural genes will code for different enzymes, so which will function for the digestion of lactose into glucose plus galactose. This is about structural genes, okay? And we have the promoter, operator. Before that, we have the regulatory gene. So this is the concept in the prokaryotes. So this whole thing is being seen in the prokaryotes. So concept, we call it as operon concept. So LacZ, this will code for beta galactosidase. LacY, this will code for lactose permease. LacA, this will code for thiogalactosidase transacetylase. So these are the three structural genes. Here we have the operator, here we have the promoter, and we have the regulatory genes initially. So this is the whole structure. So the lac operon consists of three structural genes, each involved in the processing the sugar lactose. One of them is the gene for the enzyme beta galactosidase. This enzyme hydrolyzes the lactose into glucose and galactose. Cultural situation for Escherichia coli. When glucose is present and lactose is absent, the Escherichia coli does not produce the beta galactosidase. When glucose is absent and lactose is present, the Escherichia coli will produce beta galactosidase. For this whole reason, I have made one more video about this lac operon concept in detail. Please refer to that video. Escherichia coli can use either glucose, which is a monosaccharide, or lactose, which is a disaccharide. So the lactose needs to be hydrolyzed first into glucose and galactose. So the promoter gene, it is a site for the attachment of RNA polymerase 2. It promotes the structural gene to transcribe through operator gene. So operator gene, it operates and controls the expression of structural genes. Regulator gene, it regulates the operator gene incorporation with repressor chemical. Okay. For example, we have a repressor. Repressor means repressor. Once the repressor are attached to the operator, it will stop the gene expression. If the repressor is being inactivated by lactose, it will show the gene expression. Structural genes. There are three structural genes that are present next to the operator. So LacZ, code for enzyme beta galactosidase. LacY, code for the enzyme lactose permease. LacA, code for the enzyme thiogalactosidase, transacetylase. In the absence of lactose, switch off condition. So in the absence of lactose, the repressor will bind to the operator. So once the, repressor will bind with the operator, and so the gene expression will be off. Means the RNA polymerase will not attach to promoter. So, Escherichia coli bacteria is cultured in the absence of lactose media. It would not produce the enzyme beta galactosidase. This is necessary for lactose metabolism. In this condition, the structural genes are switched off in the absence of glucose. The repressor protein synthesized by regulator genes binds to operator gene. So, the repressor protein produced by this regulator gene. So, these proteins have been produced by this regulator gene. This repressor, once attached to the operator, it will not produce any mRNA. This blocks the RNA polymerase to transcribe the structural gene. Hence, the enzymes are not produced. In the presence of lactose, it is a switch-on condition. At the presence of lactose, so the lactose will finally form into allolactose. This allolactose will act as an inducer. So, this allolactose will attach to this repressor, and this will inactivate the repressor. Now, the promoter will start the transcription. So, the Escherichia coli bacteria that are cultured in the presence of lactose media It produces the enzyme beta-galactosidase. It is necessary for lactose metabolism. So in this condition, structural genes are switched on. In presence of lactose, the repressor protein are synthesized by regulator genes, which is bind by lactose molecule. It forms a repressor-induced complex. Next, the human genome concept. The National Human Genome Research, NIH. So, US government started Human Genome Project in the year 1990, coordinated by the Department of Energy and National Institute of Health. Genome, the whole hereditary information of organisms that is encoded in the DNA, which we call it as genome. So, Human Genome Project was called a mega project because human genome has approximately 3×10⁻⁹ base pairs. The cost of sequencing required $3 per base pair. Then total estimated cost of the project is $9 billion. So the obtained sequence were to be stored in type in the form of books. In each page of the book contained 1,000 letters. Each book contained 1,000 pages. So then 3,300 such books needed to store the information for a single human cell. Aims or goals of the project: to identify the approximate 20,000 to 25,000 genes in the human DNA, to determine the sequence of 3 billion base pairs that make up the human DNA, to store the information in databases, to improve the tools for data analysis, to address the ethical, legal, and social issues that arise from genome research. Methodologies. The methods involving two major approaches: identifying all the genes that are expressed as RNA, so which we call it as expressed sequence tags. So blind approach of simplifying the sequence, the whole set of the genome that contained all the coding and non-coding sequence, later assigning different regions in the sequence with functions. Silent futures of human genome. Human genome contain 3164.7 million nucleotide bases. So the average genome consists of 3,000 bases, but sizes will vary. The largest known human genome being dystrophin has 2.4 million bases. The total number of genes is estimated at 30,000. It is the lower than the previous estimated of 80,000 to 140,000 genes. So almost all 99.9% nucleotide bases are exactly the same in all people. The functions are unknown for over 50% of discovered genes. Less than 2% of the genome codes are for proteins. So we have 246 million base pairs. So 50 million base pairs this is about. Repeated sequence make up very large portion of human genome. So chromosome 1 has most genes, 2,968 genes, and Y has the fewest, 231. So Y chromosome is the smallest. So scientists have identified about 1.4 million location where single base DNA differences, so single nucleotide polymorphism, SNPs we call it as. The information helps to finding chromosomal location for disease-associated sequence and tracing the human history. So this, and again the last concept, DNA fingerprinting. DNA fingerprinting technology. So it is the technology used for the identification of individual at genetic level. This technology was first developed by Alec Jeffries in the year 1985. So DNA fingerprinting involves identifying the differences in some specific regions in DNA sequence called repetitive DNA. So he is the one, who was born in 9th January 1950 at age 62, Oxford, United Kingdom. So Alec Jeffries, this is the photograph of Alec Jeffries. So these repetitive DNAs are separated from bulk genomic DNA at different peaks during density gradient centrifugation. So the bulk DNA forms a major peak and the other smaller peaks are referred to as satellite DNA. So this sequence shows high degree of polymorphism to form a basis of DNA fingerprinting. So the inheritable mutation is observed in a population at a high frequency. It is referred to as DNA polymorphism. So the principle of DNA fingerprinting is based on matching with VNTR's DNA collected at crime spot with suspect person's DNA. So VNTRs, variable number of tandem repeats. It also called the mini satellites that show a very high degree of polymorphism. VNTRs are very specific to individual that differ from person to person. It shows some similarities between the family members. VNTR of identical twins are same. Hence, it is not possible to identify the individuality in identical twins by DNA fingerprinting technology. Southern blotting. It is a technique of transferring the DNA from agar gel to nylon sheath. Probe. A single-stranded polynucleotide fragment complementary to specific sequence of nucleotides of DNA, which we call it as probe. It is mainly used to identify VNTRs and desired genes. So steps involved in the DNA fingerprinting is cell sample, extracted DNA and cleavage of DNA by restricted enzymes, separation of DNA fragments by electroporosis, transfer to a membrane through Southern blot, binding of radioactive DNA probe to specific DNA fragments, membrane washed free of excess probe, and X-ray film used to detect the radioactive pattern. And this is the DNA comparison between the plant A sample and plant B. So again, we have parental chromosome. So this is the paternal chromosome and maternal chromosome. So we are going to compare with this paternal and maternal. So mostly DNA fingerprinting is been used for paternal test also, paternal and both maternal test. So this is the DNA sequence. So we have to identify from the DNA from the individual A and individual B. So whose DNA will get matched? So this is the mother or father. So both together will form a child. So this is the crime scene. So which DNA has been matching? So this C is been matching with B. So at the crime scene. The DNA fingerprinting technique involved the Southern blot and hybridization using radio labeled VNTR as a probe. It include isolation of DNA, digestion of DNA by restricting endonucleases, separation of DNA fragments by electrophoresis, transferring of separated DNA fragments to nylon sheet, hybridization using labeled VNTR probe, so the detection of hybridized DNA fragments by autoradiography. Application of DNA fragment technology, fingerprinting technology. It is used to identify the criminals and rapists, to solve the paternal disputes, to solve immigrant problems, to identify the dead bodies of soldiers died in wars, to identify the dead bodies of person died at accidents and bomb blasts, to identify the racial groups, to identify inheritable disorders, to detect donor cell in case of transplantation. The DNA is isolated from a sample of blood cells, hair root cells, semen, bones collected at crime spot. The DNA of suspect also collected and isolated separately. The isolated DNA is treated with REN to cut into a number of fragments. The DNA fragments are separated according to their length on gel slab using gel electrophoresis. The DNA strand on the gel slab is treated with alkaline solution to split the double-stranded into a single strand. The single-stranded DNA is transferred to the nylon sheet using Southern blotting technique. So the single-stranded DNA is hybridized with radioactive probes of variable NTRs. The excess of probes are washed off. So nylon sheet is an X-ray photographed to get the band of VNTRs. So the bands of X-ray sheet in the DNA is the DNA fingerprint. Comparing the DNA fingerprint of sample collect at crime spot with suspect, identify the individuality. Southern blotting. The technique of transferring the DNA from agar gel to the nylon sheet, we call it as Southern blotting. Probe, a single-stranded polynucleotide fragment complementary to specific sequence of nucleotides of DNA. We call it as probe. It is mainly used to identify VNTRs and a desired gene. Yes.